definition of air conditioning system is a system giving an automatic control within predetermined limit of environment condition and by method of heating, cooling, humidification, dehumidification and cleaning and movement of air in the building. Okay, so maksudnya the definition of air conditioning system itself is they call as a system giving automatic control and of environment of within predetermined limit. So kita yang determine especially the temperature lah, kan? And especially the temperature. When the temperature changes, kan? Dia panggil the temperature change. Okay, temperature change. So dia melalui process of heating, cooling, humidification and dehumidification ni. Kan? Maksudnya contohlah you nak you punya temperature daripada suhu bilik 27 degree Celsius, you nak ke temperature of katakan 21 degree Celsius. So the changes in this temperature, dia akan melalui process of heating, cooling, humidification, dehumidification and cleaning of air ni. Okay, so the control of this condition may be desirable to maintain the health and comfort. So actually it refer back to the standard katakan standard building dekat Malaysia, you must maintain the temperature between 24 to 26 katakan. So in order to maintain the temperature, so that's why they put maksudnya all the building and especially the built environment building, kita akan gunakan aircon lah, kan. Kebanyakan bangunan dekat Malaysia kebanyakan dia gunakan aircon and compared to other country. Okay. Air conditioning unit are used to remove heat from the building so that we can maintain the cool and comfortable of internal environment. So usually lah, kan, kebanyakan building dekat Malaysia they use air conditioning system to combat the heat lah, to combat the heat because of building kita, because of the climate condition kita sepanjang tahun panas dan lembap lah, kan. So that's why kita banyak gunakan air conditioning untuk maintain the temperature, kan, to maintain the temperature. And then plus kita punya bangunan pula kita banyak menggunakan concrete building. So concrete building ni dia punya material itself dia retain heat. So that's why orang kata kalau kita boleh gunakan material-material yang lebih tidak menyerap haba, so we can reduce the air conditioning consumption lah, kan. Alright. So heat flow into a building through wall, roof, window by conduction and radiation, kan, because of kita punya climate lah, kan, because of kita punya climate. Climate ni maksudnya keadaan cuaca dekat sesebuah country tu. And kalau you pergi Scandinavian country, dia punya climate dia lain. So kita tak ada sembang pasal air conditioning system, kita sembang pasal heater, kan. Maksudnya the building industri dekat sana dia more lebih kepada heater, kan, sebab dia punya climate condition dekat sana. So in Malaysia we use a lot of air conditioning system. Okay, so people, equipment and appliance inside the building also generate heat. And so that's why the activity of the people also generate heat. Okay, so yang ni I think the advantage of air conditioning system ni is a basic lah, kan. So improve the working efficiency, suitable environment for plant growth. So you need to maintain the temperature. When you control the temperature tu lah untuk plant growth and so on lah. And also to reduce the internal and external pollution and so on. So less cleaning material and furniture last longer. Okay, so banyak lah dia punya advantages. Okay. Alright, so the factor of choosing the type of aircon and the factor of choosing the type of aircon. So first we call as a cooling load lah, and cooling load. So what is to measure this cooling load, they ada calculation for this lah, and they have the calculation for this. You need to know the size of the room, and the size of the room, the material of the building itself, and the material of the building, the size of the room ataupun ruang tersebut lah, ruang, space ataupun space. Okay, so they need to know the material, and so material yang digunakan untuk buat bangunan tersebut ataupun buat space tersebut, and then activity, so equipment, people, activity and etc, arrangement of the building and the sun direction. So dia ada, and semua ni berkait dengan calculation of cooling load. Okay, so from this cooling load, kalau dalam standard unit, kita akan pakai the unit of BTU, British, ini detail sikit lah, British Thermal Unit. And British Thermal Unit. So we can convert this BTU to horsepower of aircon. And we can convert this BTU to horsepower of aircon. So berapa horsepower nak pakai, and then system aircon tu. And katakan you nak design bangunan yang besar, yang mempunyai banyak space. So they depend on this BTU lah. And banyak ruang yang nak disejukkan ataupun nak di maintain the temperature tersebut. Okay, so what else? Water or air releasing heat from condenser. So that is the type of aircon. Okay, so the noise level and the system use, reliability, installation and cost and maintenance. Of course, this one is very, orang kata, paling crucial lah. And reliability of the system tersebut. Kalau you pakai sistem yang sangat kompleks dan susah nak buat maintenance pun susah juga. Kan? But dia adalah dia punya pro and con. Sometimes the cost of installation is cheap, and but the maintenance cost is high, and ataupun vice versa. Okay, so flexibility or user friendly. And contohnya you pakai yang paling senang sekali, you pakai split unit lah. And you pakai split unit tu yang kita selalu pakai dekat rumah kita, and yang dia have the indoor punya unit and outdoor punya unit. Okay, so that is most user friendly punya type of aircon. Okay, so yang saya cakap tadi, to maintain the temperature, kan? So what happen when the heat or cool of the air without adding the moisture? So maksudnya kita nak maintain the temperature, and also we need to maintain also the relative humidity ni kandungan lembapan dalam udara. Relative humidity. And relative humidity ni ialah kandungan lembapan dalam udara. And sometimes when you nak sejukkan tempat tersebut, katakan from 30 degree Celsius to 25 degree Celsius. So dia punya relative humidity asalnya 70%, kan? So bila you nak sejukkan, dia adding the moisture content, dia jadi 95%. So 95% is not good for orang kata not the suitable environmental condition lah. So dia punya relative humidity is too high. So that's why kita kena maintain the human comfort level, kan? Walaupun sejuk tempat tu, dia punya relative humidity we can maintain. And contohnya, this is the human comfort level of, they can maintain the temperature of 20 degree Celsius, and also the relative humidity is only between 40% to 50%. And through the process of preheating, so first dia buat a sample je lah, kan? Sample from 5 degree Celsius to 20 degree Celsius, dia panaskan udara tersebut. And then they washing and cooling to 9 degree Celsius in the washer, and then they fine heating balik, dapatlah 20 degree Celsius with 50% of relative humidity. So kita dapat achieve the 20 degrees Celsius with acceptable relative humidity. So that is called as human comfort level. So maksudnya kita dapat duduk dalam keadaan selesa when the relative humidity is maintained between 40% to 50%. Okay. Alright. So that is dia punya explanation on the human comfort level lah. And if the air enter the plant, katakan this is the they enter the plant at 5 degrees Celsius with the relative humidity of 60%, and the room air is required 20 degrees Celsius with the relative humidity of 50%. So the air will required to preheating to 18.5 degrees Celsius. So the preheating 18.5, and then they cool, they akan de-cool at 9 degrees Celsius. Ni 9 degrees Celsius. And then with the dew point temperature and finally heated back to 20 degrees Celsius. So they can achieve lah 20 degrees Celsius with the relative humidity of 40% to 50%. So this is how the process of cooling, preheating and washing lah, and to the final heating. And so katakan you nak buat control the environment. Nah, ni the case of kita nak grow the plant and with the suitable temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. Yeah. Okay, so as I mentioned previously in my lecture, so the air conditioning system kita bahagi kepada komponen-komponen air conditioning. Yang major component which is we start with compressor. Okay, compressor. And then dia pergi kepada condenser. And then dia pergi kepada expansion valve. Okay. And then dia pergi kepada evaporator. And so this is major component of air conditioning system. And also system refrigerant system pun dia gunakan sistem yang sama, which is they have the compressor, and they have the compressor, condenser, okay, expansion valve, and evaporator, okay. So usually, and kalau katakan aircon kita akan pakai split unit lah, kan. So the condenser unit ni, kan, the condenser unit ni kita letakkan dekat outside. Ni inside. Okay. So this is the fan lah, kan. Fan yang kita gunakan, fan untuk blower fan. Ni fan. Okay, selalunya the condenser unit ni kalau you beli dekat belakang ni, kalau you beli dekat belakang condenser unit ni, you akan dapat udara yang panas lah, kan, udara yang panas. So kalau you beli kat sini dekat dalam rumah, kan, so when you turn on the aircon, so the fan ni will blow at the evaporator ni, at the evaporator yang dia melalui process of air conditioning cycle, kan. So piping ataupun dia punya sistem evaporator ni, dia sangat sejuk and super cool. So when the fan blow, so you akan dapatkan udara yang sejuk. The fan blow dekat tempat yang sejuk, so you akan dapat udara yang sejuk. So this is how the air conditioning sistem beroperasi lah. Okay, so this is to be detailed. Okay, this is how dia punya system beroperasi. Okay, from point 1 to 2, and from point 1 to 2, which is dia akan melalui proses compression, and melalui proses compression. Okay, from 2 to 3 dia akan melalui proses condensation, and then from 3 to 4 dia akan melalui proses in the liquid region dia changes the state from gas to liquid, gas to liquid. So they change the state from gas to liquid. Okay, dekat sini. And then the when the apa nama dia melalui expansion valve tu, expansion valve tu dia akan release the pressure. So when they release the pressure, dia akan melalui the evaporator. So dekat evaporator ni, okay, dia punya pressure dah low. So dia dapat, maksudnya dekat tube tu, tube yang gegelung tu, dia akan masuk liquid, and liquid maksudnya super cool liquid lah. Liquid tu maksudnya gas yang kita gunakan untuk air conditioning system. Contohnya kita pakai gas R32. Okay, so gas R32 tu dia akan melalui proses penukaran daripada gas tu liquid dalam gegelung ni, condenser, and then pergi expansion valve, dia akan release the pressure and then masuk ke evaporator. So dekat sinilah dia akan melalui proses akan change the state from gas to liquid. So gas to liquid tu, liquid tu yang sangat sejuk. So when you blow the fan, so you all akan dapat udara yang sejuk dekat situ. Okay, so this is the graph of specific enthalpy versus pressure, versus pressure. Okay, so when there is a change in temperature, there is also a change in dia panggil specific enthalpy lah. Specific enthalpy ni the principle is perubahan tenaga, kan? Maksudnya kalau you nak tukar dia daripada 25 degree Celsius, katakan you nak jadikan 16 degree Celsius, so the changes in temperature ni, kan, dia akan melalui proses specific enthalpy ni, which is dalam unit kilojoule per kg. So that's why kita punya aircon kita, kita boleh maksudnya dijanakan oleh elektrik, kan, oleh sistem AC kita. So that's why kalau you daripada sangat keadaan sangat panas ke keadaan yang sangat sejuk, so you punya electric consumption tu dia sangat tinggi because of this perubahan suhu ni lah. And this perubahan suhu dia akan menggunakan tenaga yang sangat banyak, kan. So you, when you convert tenaga specific enthalpy, you convert ke kilowatt, so that's why you punya electricity bill akan tinggi disebabkan oleh perubahan suhu yang you buat tu, kan, penggunaan tenaga yang you buat tu. Okay, so that is dia punya principle lah. That is dia punya principle. So the mechanical apa nama student dia akan belajar pasal ni lah, kan, on the specific enthalpy ni. So it's good for you to know the vapor compression refrigerant system. Okay, so sistem aircon dan sistem penyejukan dia akan melalui proses this standard process, kan, from compression, condensation, liquid and evaporation. Okay, melalui proses tu. So it being detailed out in this statement, and vapor compression refrigerant system. So okay, the psychrometric chart. Okay, psychrometric chart ni being used to calculate the specific enthalpy lah, kan, apabila berlaku perubahan suhu tersebut, kan, apabila berlaku perubahan suhu. Okay, so dia ada beberapa, dia graf ni, kan, graf ni memang graf untuk orang aircon lah, orang aircon dan juga orang apa nama nak design for air conditioning system. Okay, sekarang ni dia dah ada satu app so that you can apa nama gunakan secara dalam talian je, so you dapat the exact figure. Okay, kalau dekat lab tu, so you kena gunakan this graph to produce the lab report lah, kan. So untuk subjek kita ni, good for you to know this psychrometric chart. Okay, so dia punya apa ni? Dia panggil dia punya chart ni, dia melibatkan dry bulk temperature, and this is dry bulk temperature, and then this scale, and this yang meneg ni, this scale, scale ni, ni 20, 30, 20, 25, 30 ni is the wet bulk temperature. Tengok betul-betul lah. And this is wet wet bulk temperature. Yang menegak ni, yang ke bawah ni, from negative 10, negative 5, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35 ni ialah dry bulk temperature. And dry bulk temperature. Okay. So suhu, okay. First, katakan you nak dapatkan keadaan semasa, keadaan semasa katakan 20, katakan 30 lah, 30 degree of dry bulk temperature, 30 degree of dry bulk temperature, and wet bulk temperature katakan you 20 25. Okay, dalam keadaan dry bulk temperature 30 degree Celsius and wet bulk is 25 degree Celsius. So dia akan pergi kat mana? Kalau kita tengokkan graf ni. 30 ini kita naikkan ke atas, and then 25 yang ni. So dia akan bersilang dekat this point. Betul. Dia akan bersilang dekat this point. Okay. Okay, so ni saya nak bagi contoh lah. Okay, this air move daripada dry bulk temperature 30 degree Celsius and 25 degree Celsius untuk ni, this is dry bulk and wet bulk. Disebabkan oleh you all tak masuk lab. So dia melalui satu medium. Katakan medium ni medium penyejukkan. Dan dia melalui katakan evaporator. So air yang lalu dekat evaporator ni, dia akan keluar, dia akan jadi sejuk. Dan dia akan jadi sejuk lah sebab you lalukan dia dekat cooling medium. Okay. So dia akan keluar balik with the dry temperature of, katakan saya nak lebih kurang 20, dry bulk temperature of 25 degree Celsius and wet bulk temperature of 20 degree Celsius. 20 degree Celsius. Okay. So tengok balik, dia lalu melalui medium penyejukan ni. Ni cool medium lah. Cooling medium. So this is air move. Dia lalu kan. Dia lalu satu medium penyejukan. So daripada panas ke sejuk lah. Okay, daripada panas ke sejuk. So from 25 degree suhu yang pertama tadi asalnya 30 and 25, kita dapat point dekat sini tadi. Betul? Nampak tak? I need you put this attention. Mungkin masuk dalam you punya final test nanti lah, kan? Final exams. Okay, so this cooling medium dia melalui satu cooling medium. So bila dia melalui satu cooling medium, so dia ada dry bulk and wet bulk yang baru, wet bulk temperature yang baru, which is 25. So 25 dekat sini. And then wet bulk temperature dia ialah 20 degree Celsius. So 20, which one is 20? And this one. So tempat yang bersilang tu ialah dekat somewhere here. Somewhere here. Ni. Okay. So dah ada dah satu keadaan where pen color. Okay, dah ada satu keadaan, kan? Maksudnya dia change the temperature dalam keadaan daripada 30 degree Celsius to 25 degree Celsius. So this is the changes in temperature according to the psychrometric chart. So daripada sini you boleh calculate dia punya perubahan kandungan lembapan udara dengan you tarik pakai pembaris lah, pakai pembaris kat sini, you dapat dia punya moisture content. Moisture content asal 0.008 of kg per kg of dry air. And then bila you sejukkan dia, you dapat berapa pula dia punya? Katakan you dapat 0.04 of moisture content. So daripada sini you boleh dapatkan dia punya relative humidity, berapa persen. Okay. And then you tarik pula daripada sini. Ni dapat perubahan. Perubahan lah. Perubahan. Perubahan dalam apa nama simbol segitiga tu. Okay. So you tarik pula dekat atas. You tarik pula dekat atas. You boleh dapatkan the specific enthalpy. Specific enthalpy tu stand for tarik menegak. So you dapat specific enthalpy of keadaan asal, asalnya berapa ni 50 kilojoule per kg. Okay, bila you sejukkan dia dapat perubahan specific enthalpy, tekan tarik, you dapat 30, kan? So this is you dapatkan perubahan specific enthalpy dan perubahan perubahan specific enthalpy tu. So you boleh calculate dia punya kilojoule per kg, and you boleh dapatkan dalam kilojoule per kg. And also kalau kata you nak dapatkan specific volume, you boleh menggunakan okay, so you boleh menggunakan this apa nama graph untuk dapatkan specific volume. Okay, and also apa lagi kita boleh dapatkan dekat sini. So banyak item yang kita boleh dapatkan dekat sini ialah specific volume, specific enthalpy and the moisture content. Okay, by when you use this psychrometric chart and the process, you boleh dapatkan the trend of the perubahan predetermined condition tadi tu lah, kan? Predetermined condition tadi tu. Okay, so this is how to read the psychrometric chart. Psychrometric chart, dia ada moisture content, dia ada dry bulb temperature and dia ada wet bulb temperature. And wet bulb temperature is the same line as the specific enthalpy yang you tengok dekat sini tadi. Okay, so daripada situlah you boleh dapatkan dia punya all the component-component of the moisture content, specific enthalpy and also the percentage saturation yang ada dekat sini. And this is the percentage of saturation yang dekat sini. Yeah. Okay, so daripada situ kita boleh dapatkan dia punya proses. Yeah. Contohnya kalau macam tadi tu yang saya lukis graph tu, is the process of, tadi kan dia punya graph saya tu daripada macam ni kan. Yeah. Daripada kanan ke kiri tapi bawah sikit, dia actually melalui proses cooling and dehumidification. Yeah, dia melalui proses cooling and dehumidification. And sometimes kalau you dapat proses from right to left without changes in moisture content, kan? Maksudnya moisture content tak berubah dekat kiri sekali kan, moisture content kan, moisture content dia tak berubah. So this is only the cooling process without adding the moisture content, without dehumidification, tidak melibatkan nak buang kelembapan udara. Okay, kalau proses daripada kiri ke kanan, kan, proses contoh macam ni, kiri ke kanan without adding moisture content, without dia ialah proses heating. Okay. Okay, this is the basic concept of air conditioning system using a psychrometric chart lah, and melalui proses cooling and dehumidification, cooling or heating. Okay, sometimes this psychrometric chart being used untuk design untuk complex system. Contohnya complex system tu maksudnya the combination between air conditioning system and ventilation system. And so this sistem juga sebab dalam sistem centralized unit of aircon dia melalui banyak medium. So maksudnya air tu and from point A, katakan point A, dia melalui heater dulu katakan, and ke point B, and angin tu ke point B. So dia ada dry bulb and wet bulb temperature yang baru, and then daripada B pula dia akan pergi ke point C, and this is point C. From B dia akan pergi ke point C. C pula dia melalui proses cooling medium. So melalui proses cooling medium dia ada wet bulb dengan dry bulb and wet bulb yang baru, kan. So dia melalui, kadang-kadang dia ada banyak proses dalam satu sistem because of banyak medium perantara yang dia nak lalu, kan. Angin tu dia nak lalulah. Okay, so process of cooling and dehumidification, and then sometimes the process of air heating balik, and then there akan supply air, kan. This is a process of a single duct system, kan. Okay, so this is from outside air, and then the cooling and dehumidification, and then dia akan buat proses heating balik, kan, melalui supply air ni. Okay, so psychrometric chart ni, kan, being used untuk design untuk sistem aircon kita lah, kan, sistem aircon kita. Okay. Alright, so this is how this system aircon yang lama, which is window unit, and which is all the component of aircon dalam satu unit yang sama lah. And sekarang ni dah tak banyak menggunakan window unit. Okay, kebanyakannya dah gunakan split unit. So they have the compressor, they have the condenser. Selalunya condenser ni dekat luar, kita letak dekat luar. And then kipas ni dia akan keluarkan hot air dekat luar. Okay, this is blower. Blower ni jenis fan jugalah, and jenis fan juga, type of blade dia panggil blower. So you get the cool air push into your room ataupun into the space yang you nak sejukkan tu lah. Okay, so that is the process of aircon, which is dia ada compressor, dia ada condenser, expansion valve to release the heat, to release the pressure, and also they have the cooling coil or apa dia, evaporator, and cooling coil or they call as evaporator. So that is the basic component of system aircon yang kita gunakan. Alright. Ada apa-apa soalan nak tanya berkenaan dengan sistem aircon ni? Okay, so kalau tak ada, kita je sambung sedikit lagi. Sambung pasal aircon juga, which is AHU, chiller and cooling tower. Man. Okay. Is AHU, air handling unit, chiller and cooling tower. So this is the system of centralized unit of aircon, where the component needed is AHU, air handling unit, chiller and the cooling tower. Yeah. Okay, so usually kita akan gunakan aircon jenis window unit, and mungkin dah tak ada window unit ni. Kita pakai the split unit ni. And so where the blower unit dekat dalam, so the condenser unit dekat luar. And condenser unit tu dekat luar. Alright. Or we use this type of aircon, which is a multi-split unit, where the condenser unit dia gunakan split unit yang lebih besar to supply kepada beberapa ruang di dalam satu bangunan tu. Okay, multi-split unit dipanggil multi-split unit. So the condenser, dia sama konsep dengan split unit, but the condenser unit mungkin satu unit yang besar dikongsi oleh the blower unit yang banyak di dalam satu satu bangunan tersebut. Okay, so jenis yang digunakan variable refrigerant volume ni is just nama yang diberikan lah kan, oleh Daikin lah kan, Daikin. Okay, so refrigerants. The refrigerants ni ialah gas penyejukan. Dan gas penyejukan dia ada banyak actually, gas penyejukan yang kita gunakan. And R142, R32. So ni jenis refrigerants lah, jenis gas yang kita gunakan untuk air conditioning system kita. Okay, so this refrigerant is conditioned by a single outdoor condensing unit and circulate within the building to the multiple fan coil unit. Okay, multiple fan coil unit tu maksudnya fan coil unit tu diletakkan dekat sini lah. This is FCU. Dekat sini setiap ruang ni ada FCU masing-masing and fan coil unit. So when you open you punya fan ni, so barulah dia akan blow. Kan? So sistem apa nama condenser ni bila you buka dia akan supply lah kepada dalam you punya ducting system ni. Okay. Right. So this is air handling unit. Selalunya dekat setiap ruang, setiap level dia ada satu bilik where they call as air handling unit room. Air handling AHU room. So dekat dalam AHU room tu, dia adalah komponen of komponen-komponen of air handling unit. And then FCU ni selalunya ada dekat dalam ni. Dekat dalam ni. Dekat bilik dia ada satu point dekat tepi dinding tu. So dekat situ ada FCU. So you can control the temperature from that. So this is air handling unit lah kan. Air handling unit dia ada komponen-komponen yang digunakan dan untuk supply di dalam multi space tu maksudnya banyak ruang di dalam satu satu bangunan. Okay, so dia ada exhaust air, fresh air masuk, and then dia akan supply the fresh air masuk ke dalam ruang ni, masuk ke dalam ruang ni. And ni AHU unit ni ataupun lebih dikenali sebagai centralized unit of aircon ni is actually the system ventilation plus air conditioning system. Dan sebab tu dia ada the fresh air dimasukkan dalam AHU unit ni, so dia akan gunakan centrifugal fan ni untuk push the air masuk di dalam ruang kita. And then the return air yang kita gunakan tu akan dikeluarkan, akan dikeluarkan kat sini. So this is actually the ventilation system. When you combine this system, kan, dia panggil that's why when you combine the system, dia ada cooling tower and dia ada cooling tower lah kan. Dia ada cooling tower ataupun chiller kan, ataupun chiller yang digunakan untuk menyejukkan blower ni kan. Maksudnya this is the ventilation system yang biasa. When you add the air conditioning system dekat dalam system centralized unit of aircon tu, they must have the chiller. Nah, they must have the chiller selalunya dekat atas bangunan lah. Dekat atas bangunan. Okay. Central unit of aircon consists of AHU, cooling tower and ductwork. Ductwork tu ialah ni lah. Kan? Nak bawa angin yang sejuk tu, angin di dalam, nak bawa fresh air ataupun nak bawa angin yang sejuk tu di setiap kawasan space di dalam bangunan tersebut. Yeah. Okay. So AHU unit, air handling unit is used to recondition and circulate air as part of heating, ventilation and air conditioning system. So this is the air handling unit punya component. Okay. So yang pipe color biru ni kan, nombor 4 ni, is the cooling coil, or cooling coil lah, kita tak pakai heating lah. Right. Kalau dekat overseas kita pakai heating. This is dia panggil cooling coil or evaporator. kan, evaporator macam sistem aircon split unit yang biasa tu, ataupun cooling coil. So this pipe color biru ni, yang ni yang pergi ke, yang ni yang dia akan berulang alik ke, dia akan berulang alik ke cooling tower. So cooling tower ni dia akan chill the water sajalah. So air yang masuk dalam pipe ni ialah air yang sejuk, chill water. Kan? Air yang sejuk. So bila sistem air handling unit ni dia ada, nombor dua ni ialah dia punya fan compartment. When you blow dekat something medium yang sejuk, so you akan dapat udara yang sejuk lah. Kan? Dia actually the concept of central unit of aircon ni ialah ventilation plus, kan, macam saya cakap tadi lah, ventilation plus fan. So when you punya fan ni, you blow dekat something yang medium yang sejuk, so you akan bawa udara yang sejuk masuk dalam you punya sistem, ducting system kita. Kan ni. So maksudnya when you blow daripada sini, you bawa udara yang sejuk sentiasa mengalir dekat dalam you punya ducting system ni, kan. So dia masuklah kat sini. Masuklah dekat dalam bilik satu, bilik dua, dan when you open lah, kan. When you open, dia akan dekat sini ada lagi satu fan, dekat sini ada lagi satu fan, kan. Dekat sini ada lagi satu fan lah, fan. Dekat sini ada lagi satu fan. So when you open FCU tadi, when you open the FCU tu akan the fan, dia akan bawa masuk udara yang sejuk tadi tu, yang daripada komponen-komponen inside this AHU. So inside the AHU unit, they have the supply duct, and this is the supply duct, and udara fresh air yang masuk, and then fan compartment. Nah, this is selalunya kita pakai centrifugal fan lah, and centrifugal fan. And then ni komponen-komponen accessories lah, and which is a vibrator, isolator, and then ni ialah cooling coil or evaporator unit yang pergi ke cooling tower tadi, and then filter, of course kita kena ada filter, and then dekat sini mix and recirculate air, and then barulah dia akan blow the air masuk dalam kita punya ducting system, masuk di dalam bangunan. Okay, so I think saya stop sampai sini, sampai ke AHU unit, kan. So by now you should understand how air conditioning works, kan, and also the ventilation system yang saya dah bagi lecture 3 week ago, kan. So the central unit of aircon is the combination between ventilation and air conditioning system. So actually gambar ni just nak menunjukkan dia ialah asalnya ialah ventilation system. So when you add air conditioning system dekat system tersebut, dia akan jadi centralized air conditioning system. And so when katakan dekat sini you put the pipe cooling tower yang pergi ke cooling tower ke atas, so when you blow this pipe, ataupun dia panggil cooling coil, kan, cooling coil yang dijanakan oleh cooling tower tadi tu, so you akan dapatkan udara yang sejuk yang melalui ducting system. Nah, this is ducting system you, and ducting system. Okay, so that is kita punya sistem aircon jenis centralized unit of aircon. Alright, ada apa-apa soalan sebelum kita tamatkan? Any question?
Tak ada.
Okay, alright. So kalau tak ada, I think kita stop sampai sini. So this week is for you to present your electrical design project itulah, kan. Just present macam biasa, no need orang kata to worry banyak sangat. Just saya just nak tahu you punya report tu macam mana, how you produce. Alright, so at the same time, please apa nama, study balik you punya topik-topik yang kita dah belajar, and especially for mechanical part lah, and for mechanical part. Final exam akan diberitahu lah nanti kan, final exam bila akan diberitahu. Alright, so thank you. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.